Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to a super short video all about one of the new features in the updated Davinci Resolve 17.4. And it's actually one of my new favorite features. It is the feature to upload directly into Dropbox, and I'll actually show you how this works. And I think it's pretty darn cool. So first off, if you want to link your account, you need to go up to DaVinci Resolve and go into Preferences. And in Preferences, you'll go into Internet Accounts. And here we have the Dropbox, and it's just to sign in and fill in the information and hit Save. So when you've set up your account, let's go to the next step. So let's pretend that I'm doing this video for a client, but I want to save time in rendering and sending to my client and then get his feedback and then do the changes he might want. So let's say this is our little video. We're going to go to delivery, and in the delivery, we'll just go to the Dropbox options we have right here. And I'm going to give this a name. We're just going to call this test, I think. I'll be fine enough. And location is fine. And also the different settings should be fine enough. So we could write a description if we want to, but we just need to have this checked here. So we're going to upload this directly to Dropbox. I'm going to add this into my render queue. I'm just going to say render all. And then, you know, DaVinci Resolve will do its thing and render out the fantastic video I did. And then we'll just have to see how the client responds to this, I guess. So here we are, all rendered out. And now it's just going to upload this to Dropbox. Pretty fast, actually. It's a pretty smooth process of doing that, I think. So let's drop over to Dropbox. So here we are in Dropbox. I'm just going to refresh. And here we have the video, so we're going to click that. So we can see the video here in our Dropbox. We can go through it as now we're pretending to be the client. The thing is, we can actually write comments here. And if you're using another plan that I am using on Dropbox, it's actually going to put in time marks. However, you can trick this a little around. So if we pretend that I want to take, let's say in my comments, I'm going to write something here. Let's say at 0.7, I want to have a cut. Okay, like that. And then, you know, I'm going to publish this. And then, you know, I can add in a new one. For instance, I want to remove the transition here. So I can just write again 1.3 trend. Transition remove. I'm going to publish this. So I realize that the text here is on Danish, but it doesn't matter that much. It should be the same thing. So when I jump back here in DaVinci Resolve, you see I have this new icon right up here. And if I can click here, double tap, it's going to open up my notes. So I can actually go through my notes here. 07, okay, I'll go to 017. Like that, okay. I'll just go back here. And my client has written cut. Okay, so I'm going to cut this piece out here, and I'm going to go up here, and then you can actually toggle these off, and you can write a comment back if you want to. And then I also need to take the transition out. I can see here, let's see what you write here. Okay, transition remove. Okay, so I have a transition he wants me to remove. Zoom in here, and I'm just going to remove my transition. and I can then give myself a highlight. So I've done all of these things. I can then send this back to the client. He can approve, and I can send him a high res version of the video I was doing for him. So I think this is a super nice feature in DaVinci Resolve 17.4. And remember, if you're having another plan on Dropbox, you can actually put in time stamps or time marks. But since I didn't have that, you can still use this method of getting the feedback right from your client if they just write in a time code. I've done this on so many projects over the years, so it's actually pretty nice to have all your notes inside of your editing program. Okay, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.